At the western end of the Republic of Indonesia, off the west coast of the mainland of Sumatra, lie the Mentawayan Islands. At the heart of the chain, Siberut. Most of the 17,000 Mentawayans on Siberut have begun in varying degrees to be assimilated into the modern world. However, some small clans living in the dense rainforest interior still retain their own culture. This is one of them. Our time with the Sakuddei was spent with a Swiss anthropologist whom they have adopted as a member of the clan. Dr. Reimer Scheffold.
The clan house, the Uma, is a village under one roof. Here live 8 families, 41 men, women and children. The house has 3 rooms, the front for relaxing, the center room with a communal hearth and the dance floor, and the rear room where the women do household work and take care of the smallest children. Here too is a place of the Bakat Gatsaila, the main fetish of the Uma, a bundle of holy leaves.
Breakfast is at dawn. Sago flour, sometimes mixed with coconut, grated, stuffed in its own leaves, and roasted. The Sakuddei diet is hardly attractive to a European palate, but it is solid, nourishing, and there's plenty of it. At normal times, half the clan are away from the Uma, some gone downstream to trade at the coast, some visiting neighbours, most dispersed around the clan territory in their plantations. This couple, Amandu Matkeri and his wife Baidu Matkeri, are on their way to their own family house.
The Sakuddei have no leaders, and decisions are made collectively, with men, women and children free to offer opinions. But some individuals do have particular subjects which they know more about than the others. Amandu Matkeri is a man full of initiatives. He communicates easily. He understood very quickly that things which are obvious to a Sakuddei are not necessarily obvious to us. Half the time, this is their home. Here they keep their pigs and chickens. They have their own fruit trees and gardens, and since men and women must sleep apart in the clan house, here they will sometimes stay just for privacy and tranquility. You choose yourself who you want to marry. There are no arranged marriages, no chief's daughters as diplomatic pawns. But the system does have a political content. Marrying into another clan means exchanging gifts, becoming related, developing a kind of alliance. There's a lot of aggression between the 20 or so clans living along the river, and since there is no political unit beyond the clan, every quarrel could easily lead to real fighting. But having in-laws all over the place helps to keep the peace. You can feel secure in your own territory.
Amanda McCary owns this tree in the sense that only he can chop it down or give it away. But any other member of the clan can take a couple of coconuts anytime he feels like it, and he doesn't have to ask first.
Coconuts are especially important as they are the main thing the Mentawaians can offer the people from Sumatra in exchange for iron tools, cloth and tobacco. But the range of goods is limited, and a point is soon reached when owning more doesn't make any sense. Your daily needs are easily satisfied, the soil is fertile, and space is abundant. There is much leisure. The Sakuddei may be at a Stone Age level of development, but it has always been my impression that it's a luxury Stone Age. Moile moile is their favorite saying. Don't hurry, don't hurry. The Sakuddei have no such thing as work specialization. When I explained to them the idea of specializing in boat building, say, or tool making, they laughed and said, how boring that would be. Every man can perform all the tasks appropriate to men, every woman all the tasks appropriate to women. Together, they produce all that is necessary for the household. This sago palm is fodder for Amanu Matkere's pigs, or it could make flour for cooking either at the field house or communally at the Uma. Baidu Matkere, meanwhile, prepares fence posts for her taro field. She works with her tegle, or machete, Amanu Matkere with his axe.
But Amanda McCary does have one activity that almost counts as a speciality, which he happens to share with only half the other men in the clan.
These two women show the symptoms of what we call malaria. But the Sakuddei don't see illness merely as a matter of physical disorder. There are always supernatural powers involved, which have usually been aroused by someone's neglect of a taboo. The Sakuddei perceive a harmony in their environment, and their taboos are part of a constant effort to maintain that harmony. These women have carelessly offended the spirits of the forest by working there in a taboo period. The angry spirits have brought supernatural force to bear, and they have become sick.
Oh,
The slip drums summon the members of the clan to gather in the umma. While we were living with the Sakuddei, a baby was born. About a week later, the little girl was brought out of the clan house for the first time and ceremonially bathed in the river.
This marks her entry into the outside world, and it is an event which concerns the whole clan. It is an occasion for a puliaijat, the big communal feast of the Sakuddei.
Preparations for the festival began the next day. 'Wisa, one of Amandamat Kere's brothers, is carving a bird. Another brother, Aman Pabubukere, makes the wings. The finished carving will be placed on a specially erected porch in front of the umma. Amandumat Kere explains what the birds mean.
You must lead an attractive life, or your soul will desert you. But in daily life, you are often forced to do things which may injure your relationship with your soul. You work hard, you eat poorly, you are in a hurry, you may lose your temper. So, before the ceremony gets underway, the whole clan passes through a symbolic gateway, and each member leaves behind the routine of daily life. Now, during the festival, everything which pleases the soul will be enhanced.
Yeah.
This is what missionaries would probably call pagan babel. But it makes sense. For the Sakuddei, everything that exists is alive. Everything has a soul. By calling upon the souls of things, you can influence what is going to happen. There are certain holy plants which act as mediators. They bridge the gap between men and the world of the souls. Here, every member of the clan is invoking a plant called Katsaila, which means the one who diverts. But not only plants can act as mediators. Here, before it is sacrificed, the soul of a pig is invoked to keep away all evil and attract good forces. But first, the pig is asked forgiveness. Don't be angry, pig, they say. We have to kill you, but don't forget how we have always looked after you. Don't forget you only became so fat because we fed and protected you. With the souls now attracted to the ceremony, they must be protected. All the evil spirits which have nested in the Uma since the last ceremony must be expelled. After chanting round the bucket Katsaila, the medicine men come to see these spirits and are struck by their powerful radiations. They enact a dramatic struggle with the spirits, beating them out of the clan house and falling constantly into trances. A puliaijat often lasts for weeks and may contain dozens of separate rituals. On this, the May night, the Sakuddei danced till dawn. It is deep in the night. The Sakuddei feel their souls to be very near. It is time to entertain them by dancing in the fire.
The intention of the government is within the shortest possible time to uplift the social conditions of the people concerned. But of course, without shocks, this you can know for sure, without shocks. And bit by bit, bringing them into contact with the general development of the Indonesian society. We want them to bring them up in the states that they can understand us, you know, that what is health for, what is hygiene for, what is a school for, just the elementary conditions that I think is standard for every normal society in this modern world.
Empat, satu, dua, tiga.
Indonesia, tanah airku, tanah tumpah darahku. Di sanalah aku berdiri, jadi pandu ibuku. Indonesia.
Like most of the schools on the island, this one is on the coast. For the Sakuddei children, there is at present no school in reach and no prospect of one. We asked the adults if they would welcome a school. Yes, they said, but we will not let our children go away to the coast. The school must be upriver.
Jene oso ulia khaya na sia jene ane datang ko ulia aja. Oto kukut kai kunen ane datang ko kunen. Dari de psikola dari de ulia aja. Ya se kumo bakai.
Dua lua.
Datang ko duduk ni ya.
Dari di pusikola karaja tua dari di karaja pusaina karaja pumone oto ne zira icha oto ka ida jugul dai kaparang sabe galaja cari wale raicha sabe sekolah le raicha oto ana kubile ka shaina ka ina kubile ka sinu guluru nia dunia bagi bagi pulia jat tanara pa tanara
buku
tanara ai tanara
icha
oto sura gesi mo ba ida ka ya
mo ba ai ida pa ai ta ida sura Pakai tarot, pakai taru.
Ya, le, ane Bu itu bebe kakai, kakai. Ku ne mai galajib mai samadra. Bu itu bebe ne dak mata da surat.
Their economy is so scattered. So they have their coconut field somewhere. They have to go with the small boat for a couple of hours or what, and then back again, you know, in the afternoon. And so on. And if we want to regulate the society, it's very difficult for us because here there are 10 huts, there are 5 huts, and here, you know, it's impossible to execute a good system of government. Now, by having, reorganization of the village, it is much more easier for us to have our guidance, you see, to bring them up, and see, so that they can go to school, what, within 1 hour or within half an hour. For instance, so a school has a meaning, a polyclinic has a meaning, you know, education and all this kind of thing has a meaning if things are, you know, more close together. This is the basic idea.
This is one of the government's new villages on the coast, Pasakiat. The people we spoke to here were not happy. Among their complaints was the absence of the traditional umma. We asked one man how many people lived in his particular house.
Chandiniya tarakau.
Oto maboy to yesuwa pano makukika.
Ta barani ke ma kena maboy to yabaja kukuduja kaita poy ke mauju ka shene kugale ka shabeu. Ta shene te shene.
Kukunu kunu nene.
Oh. Ta yo ba ka manye baja. Ame
nene kutsu sabe.
Kugale ka shabeu ka.
Oto kasi sipasi kala iya musore ka
tu. Ta kaile mugale baja. Kugale ka bantuan shimantau le pa.
Other people on the coast tell similar stories. This community, my Lepet, has the reputation of trying more than most to keep up the traditional way of life. Sitting on the front porch of the umma, one of the medicine men explains why.
Pasigalai tege tak kuai kai, durunya pamasi-masi tak kuai kai. Oto ia lewai kupulu tete mai pulilia, puke kere, pasilaget, ia tak kuai pake kai. Oh. Ia te tak kuai pake kai, gaut gogo mai, gaut sainak mai, kuduma mai, ia tak kuai pake kai.
Pangalak
niba. Airunu ake, pulu tete mai, utet niba, sibarakat tete mai.
Apa pak onin pora nanenda ka Indonesia? Kalulu nenek sasaraina. Anai Katolik, anai Protestan, anai Islam, anai Buddha. Epat arak ka Indonesia nenek. Iyo ba ake, ele iyo ake pamarenta bule tenung ake samrenta sipuni pamian. Kalulu nenek sasaraina. Bule tatun.
Some of the islanders see no conflict between their old beliefs and Christianity and have tried to follow both. It has landed these three men in trouble with the police.
May kasita si Sayla Sita, kabagat puto ni mambagata, kalulut, ay pehile katalagata si magura to nimbaga.
Yeah, man.
They have conducted a clandestine ceremony to initiate a new medicine man, something which provokes a strong reaction from the police chief.
Tolong sampaikan ya. Sekiranya dilarang. Sebabnya dilarang adalah menghalangi kemajuan. Kalau memakai skere, berarti memakan waktu nan panjang. Dan lagi pun, tidak bisa menyatakan orang itu laki senang atau cepat sembuh. Sebabnya skere adalah bukan memeriksa penyakit dengan sebaik-baiknya.
Tapi kalau tak ayo pak, tak ayo itu bumai nenek arah Cibau, nenek ibali magulai patuat mai. Ibali magulai. Apa tak cibara ke patuat mai? Kini ke kita naik ngangan pemerintah kita gila kai pemerintah. Sang ambil tak kau sepuluh kudu kami tahu eh toilet siapa? Parsa bulungan itu. Ia te imai kita kuah. Karisten nek oh. Tapi ke barang orang indah si kere lah sokai.
Kere.
Kalau napa kalau lu putol iman bagara kata buat sekere.
Padahal sekere itu sendiri tidak menyembuhkan penyakit menurut pendapat dalam alam kemajuan sekarang. Dan dari pemerintah mengurangi sekere ini dengan tertulis kepada kami. Supaya sekere-sekere ini berangsur-angsur dihapuskan.
Kalau malegre kai sekalengan lagi, nore maki apa aja. Kalau tak naik sipok ni ya, tapa ipo. Besit baga, tanai kasih kerei. Kaya pale besit baga, karok toro le kementari. Oto si kunanan itu tanai kementari. Kaya pale ibarah kasih kerei. Oto ini tak besit kai si baja, si tereke mukerei. Tapi kile tak kuat imagai ka pemerintah daukum le.
Atau dari apa yang telah saya lihat, si bulungan itu upacara-upacaranya pernah saya lihat. Tetapi saya menganggap karena pengertian mungkin bagi saya, bahasa itu bukanlah suatu agama. Hanya merupakan satu kepercayaan yang tidak mendalam kepada pribadi orang itu sendiri. Sebetulnya upacara-upacara agama boleh dikatakan tidak ada. Cuma yang ada upacara perkawinan, upacara mati, dan upacara pengobatan. Tapi yang khusus menyembah daripada ini boleh dikatakan, saya tahu belum ada.
Cukuplah semua suruh sini kuliah lagi. Ini kemah itu sebuah hunik katetina, ini kahuluk nani, apakun yang kain ngantar si kasat. Apakun yang kau bunah si kasat. Bahas itu yang kain sebelah kasat masih ekeu. Semua beli kain katubun masih ekeu. Alah si dia katubun masih ekeu. Kalau ni ia yuri, kalau ia bulan katubun, ia yuri seruan. Gije koya koya le kuya tis kaba kuyu mucina kaba kali kala kuyu cipula ho kacari kita kasih lihat pola sa sesile na hoy pulang kala katumai lo hoy sitali mai da ke alah ke mai da ke ngo mai da ke kayo mai da ke kila bu mai pola sa le mai pulu le lo ta ya liet ta li ka ori sta ya ka bola ka sta ya ka sialu wat ka tu ngo ba pola ho toy na elaga kitu lo lo pa lo lo da ke alah ke mai lo lo puri manu mai lo lo ka baba ja mai.
For the Sakuddei, there is no distinction between their religion and all their other traditions. Everything has been handed down from the ancestors who set the example of how life should be. This has led to conflict with the authorities, often on apparently trivial matters.
Could I ask why you think it's necessary that the Mentoran should cut their hair?
Well, you see, every society has a kind of, value systems, and I think we like here, you know, to bring the people up so that you shouldn't be different with the others. I tell you what, just 1 year ago, this Sakuddei group, you know, they came over here and voluntarily, you know, they asked the governor to cut their hairs. I have done it. But this is important because behind this, there's a story that if you explain it to them and, you know, so that they can accept, so they are willing to do it voluntarily. And I agree with you, I don't agree a harsh action towards this people.
Kita mati siya kahit yeti na ne buk mati mai ko kira kahit mula kira mai na opul gulung mai opul na nu mai opul lei lei yeta.
The Sakuddei tell a different version of the affair than the governor, but he didn't know the full story. The Sakuddei say they were threatened by two government officials during a prolonged argument the night before they met the governor. Having browbeaten the Sakuddei into volunteering for haircuts, the government men subsequently produced, by way of compensation, one wig for the 8 adult men of the clan.
The wig is usually worn by Teuisa, not without embarrassment. Teuisa is thus the only man in the clan who is any longer properly dressed and decorated for ceremonial occasions. Here he performs the eagle dance, with the others miming the irritating attentions of some monkeys.
If I'm convinced on my next trip that this is really a basic problem for them, having long hair or not long hair, in the sense that it will hurt or hamper the other program of the government, well, I'm willing to make changes.
Schools and missionaries, and they have had occasional brushes with the police. But as yet, they know nothing of the newest and potentially the biggest threat to their way of life. They don't know and wouldn't understand that their clan territory is inside the boundaries of a vast concession granted by the Indonesian government to a Filipino logging company. How much of the island has been given out in concessions?
I think we have by now about 8 concession holders.
And what proportion of the area of the island do you think that is?
Oh, you see, on paper, all the islands are already divided in regions. In regions, though, but according to our policy, they are only allowed to cut trees that has been proven by our forestry department. So it is not a clear, except for making roads, they are not allowed to cut every tree. The minimum requirement for that is a 60 centimeter diagram, mm-hmm. which is the minimum, because due to the age of trees and so on and so on, we have our own regulations for that. So it must be a selective cutting.
Have you had any problems with the local population at all?
Well, sometimes there are few, but it's only slight because, when we construct a road, for instance, they claim damages with the coconut trees and other plantation. But with the help of the Indonesian official right in Siberut, we solved all the problems.
I heard a story that you had some equipment burnt last March by some of the local people. What was that?
Well, sometimes we don't know whether it is natives or burn those equipments or to our men, Filipino workers. Might be there is an underground or I don't know, but until now we do not know the. We have not solved the case who burned that equipment.
You did have some equipment then?
No, it is only, I think, 3 censors. They are only 2. That's the only happening which we encountered in this island.
Have any of the people of the island ever asked for compensation?
Well, there are sometimes. But, we just give a contribution to the last success of the army partner. What we call Pachamat.
You give a contribution?
Yeah, for the government official here in Siberut.
Well, you pay money to the government official?
Yeah. But that's not... they did not ask for us, but we only give a form of contribution every month.
It is easy to say stop the logging, but this province of Indonesia has an annual income of $17 million from the timber concessions on the islands, and this money is needed. Any schemes to protect the forest, to protect the rare animals, or to help the Mentawaians themselves will have to take that income into account. The authorities say they are prepared to listen to ideas.
Think that your output is going to go up in the future?
Well, through our forecast, which every month we have target production, and if we can hit the target production, of course we can have a profit, Paul. And we will not continue if, of course, we'll be the target that we have, we cannot get it.
Are you on target at the moment?
Yeah, we have a target. Okay. We have a target production every month.
And what is the target production every month?
Well, by transferring in the new area, we have a target production of 20,000 cubic meters a month.
20,000 cubic meters a month.
As soon as the equipments arrive. We are expecting our equipments will arrive by next week or end of this month.
And how many trees is, roughly speaking, how many trees is 20,000 cubic meters?
Well, 20,000 cubic meters, 5, 3, 6, around 6,000 pieces, you know.
6,000 trees?
Yeah.
A month?
A month.
Mau bak kuai kap. Cui suap kuai bakat dong arula. Oto manu tu bakamui pasang arula oi. Takaja bang asang pasang arula oi. Mau bak oto kukut kai ane ne uma sabagi oto tak ana nang kaje ne gaba gaba lele ngam ni tak kuai mai sibau. Jate pabalo wi tata kuai ni tu bak tak kuai mau julek noi toi.